So you're about to graduate with a STEM degree, but you aren't too sure exactly where to go to find yourself a tech job. Then you've come to the right place. Today, I'll talk to you about the best tech graduate jobs in Australia and give you a general lay of the land when it comes to finding tech opportunities. I'm Samanvare, a data scientist living in Sydney, Australia. So why should you listen to me when it comes to finding tech jobs? I've spent the past 5 years being a data scientist and a data engineer in all types of companies, from startups to established tech companies to corporate companies. And I've also got multiple friends and colleagues who have got into tech following a variety of pathways. So these experiences have given me a pretty good gauge as to what getting a grad job in tech entails. Once you've graduated, there are three types of companies that you can be working for. The first is a startup. The second is a scale-up or an established tech company. And the third is corporate organizations such as banks or consultancies. For each of these three types of organizations, I'll walk you through the pros and cons of working there so that you can make the best decision for your circumstances. So let's talk about startups. Startups are private organizations that have anywhere from 5 people working there to 100 or 200 people. Let's talk about the pros and cons of working in a startup. So the first pro is that given the small size of the company, you'll be given a lot of responsibility right off the bat. This means that you'll be learning at a breakneck speed, and you won't be limited by your job title as to what you do on a day-to-day basis. For example, my first job was in a 50-person startup. Even though I was hired as a data analyst, over the 2 years that I was there, I did everything from the work of a data scientist, data engineer, and a software engineer, mainly a back-end developer. Over the 2 years, I worked on a very large scope of work, which gave me a breadth of experience, which helped me guide where I wanted to go next in my career. So as a startup, you're definitely not limited by your job title. The second pro is that startups operate with a generally flat structure, which means that there's very little hierarchy in place. So this means that you could well be seated next to the CEO of the company, and there aren't many places where you'd get that kind of an experience. So this flat structure means that you have a lot of autonomy in the way you get your job done. But be warned though, because this comes with a lot of responsibility. But if you're someone that doesn't wait to be told what to do and thrives as a self-starter, then startups is the perfect environment for you. The third pro is that you'll be working with very switched on and smart workmates who are extremely fun to be around. Due to budget constraints, startups can only afford to hire a limited number of people, which means that they need to make every hire count. And this in turn translates to hiring the best of the best to get the job done well. So usually hiring at a startup has a very high bar. So it's not all sunshine and rainbows working at a startup. So let's talk about a couple of the cons of working at one. So startups make for very intense working environments. As I mentioned earlier, you're gonna get a lot of responsibility right off the bat, which means that work-life balance is not the best. So at times it's very easy to burn out if you're not too careful with setting your boundaries from day one. Next con is that pay is usually less than market value. Now, this can't be easily generalized across all startups because a 50-person startup is very different to a 100 or 200-person startup, which is extremely well-funded. But usually, startup pay is not the best, which can be a con for a couple of people. But startups, as I mentioned, is where you want to be going if you want to maximize learning. And usually, if you've got a couple of years of experience at a startup, you can easily make up for that difference in the next role that you have after a startup, because startup experience is very valuable out in the industry. Lastly, you'll have a bit of an imposter syndrome when working at a startup. Because you're surrounded by the best of the best, you definitely won't be the smartest person in the room. Especially if it's a small company, you'll be surrounded by executives, founders, and people from all walks of life. But this is also a pro. As I mentioned earlier, this is gonna maximize your learning potential. So now that you know the pros and cons of working at a startup, how do you find these startup jobs? There's lots of incubators and VCs in Australia like Startmate or Blackbird Ventures that run their own hiring platforms, and they also have lots of fellowships that you can apply for to get your foot in the door in the startup community. Other than that, there's also a Slack community called Early Work, where you'll find the best and brightest of Australia in the tech industry. And there's lots of jobs that are posted in that forum. So I would say that's the place to be if you're looking for startup jobs. Let's talk about working at an established tech company or a scale-up. Examples of these types of companies include Canva, Atlassian, Google, or Afterpay. A lot of these companies tend to be publicly listed companies, and most of them have more than 1,000 or 2,000 employees. So there's lots of pros to working at established tech companies. The first pro is that you'll be very well looked after. The salaries at these companies are usually better than market standard, and there's heaps of perks and benefits working at these companies. The second is that the hiring standard at these companies is fairly high. So this is the perfect place to be if you need strong mentorship and if you're interested in working with extremely smart people. So this is a great place to be as a graduate, because there's going to be great structured mentorship program and you'll be learning quite a lot on the job. The third pro obviously is the brand name. The brand name of these companies can open a lot of doors for you once you decide to leave that company. For example, if there's candidates with Canva or Atlassian on their resume, then they're automatically associated with a brand of excellence. In terms of cons, the first is that you'll be a part of a very large organization, which means that the impact of your work is rather narrow. Your roles and responsibilities are very well defined and structured, so there isn't much scope for you to step outside of the boundaries of your title. So it's not the same as in a startup where you get a chance to be exposed to different operations of the company. But this might be a pro depending on your personality, because sometimes given the size of a startup, the operations inside the company can be quite ambiguous and chaotic. The second con is that there is a lack of transparency and hidden politics in majority of the large organizations. It can take you a couple of months to even understand how your team operates, let alone how other teams fit into the big picture. So if you're someone that finds it frustrating how the big picture operates on the grand scheme of the company, then working at established companies won't be too good for you. And the last cons is that these companies are extremely competitive to get into. A lot of these companies have very regimented hiring process. Some of the interviews for these companies can last as long as 5 rounds, which can be a couple of weeks of interviewing. So it can be quite frustrating if you're not prepared for a long, arduous hiring process. And sometimes tech people joke that the hardest part of the job at these tech companies is actually the interview. So how do you apply for these companies? So applying for these companies is very similar to applying at startups. And I would also recommend hitting up people that are working at these companies already and asking for a referral, because a referral is the best way to ensure that you secure a job interview. Finally, the last option for you as a tech graduate is to work for large organizations such as banks or consultancies. So example of these companies in Australia include Westpac Bank, Commonwealth Bank, Big Four consultancies like PwC or Deloitte, or consultancies like BCG or McKinsey, which have digital, tech, and data arms. So the first pro of working in these types of organizations is that you'll learn a lot of soft skills. These types of organizations are great to really improve on your stakeholder management skills, sales skills, speaking, and presentation skills. So if you're someone that values these types of skills in addition to your tech skills, then these types of organizations are the place to be. The second con is that, especially if you're working in consultancies, you'll be exposed to problems in a wide variety of industries. This is definitely not the case if you're working in startups or established tech companies, where your role is very siloed. So these types of opportunities are great to explore your interest in a variety of industries, especially if you don't know which industry appeals to you the most. Let's talk about the cons. So one of the cons of working at these places is that these places aren't the best to improve on your tech skills. Whilst these organizations are decent at hiring technologists, the best of the best are going to be poached by the leading tech companies out there. So if you're looking to chisel your tech skills, these organizations organizations might not be the best place for you. The second con is that these organizations have a very rigid hierarchical structure, which means that there's a lot of red tape to getting anything done within the company. And this might be very frustrating because you'll definitely won't get as much autonomy as you think you might like. So the third con is the internal politics of these organizations. Similar to established tech companies, these companies have its own politics to be dealt with. And this is not really the best to maximize your learning early on in your career. But from one perspective, learning how to deal with politics can also be an advantage. But in my opinion, you're gonna learn that sooner or later. The fourth and last con is the hiring process at these companies. All of these companies have very structured graduate programs, which means that you're gonna have to jump through a lot of hoops to secure a job because literally thousands and thousands of people are applying to these organizations every single year. And these organizations have a lot of money to put behind their marketing campaigns. So don't be surprised when you're graduating and you start seeing lots of ads from these types of organizations. So those are all the options you have when you're applying for tech grad jobs in Australia. If you're someone that's passionate about maximizing their learning and working with really, really smart people, then I couldn't recommend startups highly enough. So at a startup, you'll not only learn tech skills, but you'll also learn how tech businesses function. If you're someone that prefers a structured and well-defined role and you value getting a relatively high starting salary, then established tech companies are the place to be. Here, you'll get tons of benefits of working there, as well as solid mentorship to allow you to progress in your career. Finally, you should only consider going to a corporate organization like a bank or consultancy if you value developing skills other than your tech skills. And it's really useful to go to these organizations if you know you'd like to pursue consulting as a career in the future. That's it for the video. If you enjoyed it, then smash that like button and I'll see you next time.